Hi there, I'm Alexandros Tantos, and I'm working as Assistant Professor of Text and Computational Linguistics at the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki in Greece. I've been working on a number of projects spanning from computational linguistics and natural language processing to corpus linguistics. Recently, I've started applying machine learning algorithms on language data for improving our understanding as to how a second language is processed and acquired. I've been using R and Python for my courses and my data analysis for the last 10 years. So, how come I start working on Julia? Well, here is my story. Recently, I applied and got a research fund for a project on modeling language data generated from learners of Greek as a second language. The idea is that one can actually reveal hidden aspects of the error profiles of the learners. The research plan includes three online experiments using an eye tracker. Eye tracking, for those who don't know it, is a sensor technology that makes it possible for a computer to trace where a person is looking as she reads the text. An eye tracker provides unique insights into second language understanding, since it can detect the presence, attention, and focus of the speaker. Eye tracking data are really rich data, since they include time and space related coordinates. Naturally, I started looking for alternative languages that would be fast in processing arrays of such type of data, and naturally, I stumbled upon Julia. It definitely caught my attention from the first moment, and quickly I realized that you can express your implementation ideas in a clean and concise way. I also liked a lot the idea of using LaTeX-compatible characters on my code. While learning the language, I thought that a good first project would be to create a simple linear regression model in Julia on the basis of some language data I got to have from second language learners of Greek. I did that last September, and I also felt the need to share the code and the process through a YouTube video on my channel. You can go ahead and have a look at it if you like. Coming back to the eye tracking experiments I talked about a minute ago, we are in the first phase of the project and the experiments are not ready yet. However, if there is anyone out there who has already used Julia for experimental purposes or of the same or similar kind in the humanities or in psychology, I would be excited to share thoughts and ideas. Last but not least, being a new Julia user, I've had two very good incentives to approach and adopt Julia. First, the documentation is really helpful, with many clear examples, something that's, believe me, it's greatly appreciated by a new user like me. And B, the community, as it behaves in Julia discourse and in Zulip, is helpful and kind and patient to newbies' questions. So then the question, why Julia, becomes why not Julia?